Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see another way to access aldol type products. On screen, we have two reactions. The top is our familiar aldol reaction with its familiar three steps. Start with a ketone. One, add LDA. Two, add an aldehyde. Three, add water. That gives a beta-hydroxyketone. This is the aldol reaction in these three steps. We can treat the product with a base like sodium ethoxide or sodium hydroxide to make an alpha-beta-unsaturated ketone by an elimination, since in this elimination we lose water, we can also call it a dehydration. The bottom reaction, which is called the aldol condensation, different from the reaction, it's a condensation, gets us to the exact same product. It doesn't even require multiple steps. Just mix a base, sodium hydroxide or an alkoxide, with the ketone and aldehyde, and out pops the alpha-beta unsaturated ketone. How? Well, let's see exactly how this aldol condensation works. It's very similar to the aldol reaction. So our mechanism starts with the ketone. The base, sodium ethoxide in this case, deprotonates at the alpha carbon to form an enolate. Now, we clearly learned that alkoxides aren't strong enough to form a high concentration of enolates. That's okay. We don't need a high concentration. A low concentration is fine for this reaction. As soon as a small amount of enolate forms, it looks for an electrophile because it's a nucleophile. It finds the aldehyde, which is already floating in the reaction. The enolate attacks the aldehyde and forms our tetrahedral intermediate, in the aldol reaction, the intermediate needed to wait for a proton source. Not so in the condensation. We have a proton source immediately available. It's the conjugate acid of our weak base, ethanol, in this case. This forms our beta-hydroxyketone, The beta-hydroxyketone forms in the presence of the base of our reaction, in the presence of the sodium ethoxide. This beta-hydroxyketone will be deprotonated by the ethoxide to form an enolate. The enolate electrons lean over, kick out hydroxide as a leaving group, and that forms our final alpha-beta unsaturated ketone. Wow, this is so much easier than the same ultimate molecule through the aldol reaction and a dehydration. Just dump everything together and let the reaction take care of itself. Well, the aldol reaction process tends to work better in general, and the aldol reaction route does allow you to stop at the beta-hydroxyketone, which is impossible with the aldol condensation. But the aldol condensation method is certainly simpler and was discovered first, like decades earlier. So we have potentially two methods to prepare alpha-beta unsaturated ketones. Either use the aldol reaction with an additional elimination, or use the aldol condensation.